All right, there we are again, I think. Let's test again, of course, to see if the audio is actually working. Maybe I'm talking too early because the screen is still black. Okay, one person watching, so...
Of course, to see if the audio is actually working.
Well, there's the answer to that. Okay, then. So, today we're going to... continue this run, and today we're going to suffer because we're going to fight the four kicks, which is going to be absolutely terrible. All right, so I see two people have already joined, but of course, like always, I have to actually allow people to allow people time to enter the chat. So just like always, I'm going to wait a minute, like 5 minutes or so, and then we're going to continue the run, so we're going to allow people to enter the chat, and if you watch this after the stream is already done, you will find a timestamp in the pinned comment. Alright, let's get going. Well, let's get going in 5 minutes, I should say. All right, there I am. Oh boy. Is everyone excited for part two? Yeah. Okay, actually, I'm not so excited because I'm going to have to fight the four kings while fat rolling, so that's gonna suck. Okay, so how's everyone doing? So, Lord Alctus asked me what possessed you to do this run. Stupidity, probably. But there we go. And how was my weekend? Work. I always work on weekends. Well, except, of course, I'm not working today. But yesterday I had to work. You have a little over 2 hours that you can watch. Okay, that's good. So that's at least half the stream. I never go past 12 o'clock after all, because then the downstairs neighbors are going to complain about noise. And no, that's not a joke. I wish it was. So, you wish you didn't have to work tomorrow. Well, I also have to work tomorrow, so what kind of work I do? Stupid work. There you go. So, part two of the fat rolling Iron Golem run. I just prepared my equipment, which is good, because of the special attack from the Golem Axe, I have to watch out for that. Well, actually, I have 85 repair powder, so it's not that relevant in that sense. But now, at the end of the previous stream, we ended by acquiring the Lord Vessel. So now we have to get the four Lord Souls, and given that the four kings are going to be the biggest problem, other than the DLC, of course, I ended the previous stream by unlocking the shortcut towards the four kings, and now we're going to fight the four kings and die. Alright. Oh, we're still... Yeah, you are completely right. Okay. But he said a potato. The chances that you can actually enter my world are kind of small, I would say. But okay, fine. I'll go human. Of course, every time I die against the four kings, that is going to rob me of a bit of humanity. And also in the game, by the way. So... Oh, you have to go to work in a couple of hours. Oh, it's Monday morning over there. Oh, so you live in the Far East, Oliver Jill? Huh? Oh, wait, that's not... Yeah, that should be the case then. Ah. The 5-4 kings. Well, there are only four... Well, actually, there is a fifth 4 king that's below the area that's hidden out of sight because it serves... That's the way it is designed to... basically the placeholder for the shared life bar. Ah, New Zealand. Oh. Basically, that's as far as you can travel. Because if you travel any further than that, you're basically coming back already. And just like Australia, do you have like absolutely terrible... terrible things like giant spiders and that kind of stuff? Because then I don't exactly envy where you live. 6-4 kings. Well, a lot of people think that there are more than four kings, but it's simply that when the four kings... When you kill a king, he simply respawns, so... There are actually five kings that spawn above. No, the fifth one is hidden beneath the boss arena. No, just kiwi birds, okay. Actually, I should get rid of these because I don't need to fight the ghosts anymore. I'll probably need my humanity to because I will constantly be healing. Not that I can really tank through the four kings' attacks anyway. Well, unless I'm very close to them, so that only the hilt of their sword hit me, then I take massively reduced damage. But still, yeah, it's going to be an issue. Oh, don't forget the Abyss Ring, you're absolutely correct. Of course, I need to first get to the boss arena. But you are absolutely correct, if I jump down without equipping the ring, that's an issue. Also, I am going to use Power Within. Although I haven't picked up the version of Power Within that you can get in this game cycle, so I can have free usages, but then again, I don't even know if the fight is long enough for that, and of course it also has the problem that it drains my health. And my health is basically something I constantly will be replenishing anyway because of their attacks that I can't reliably dodge. Sorcerer's Four Kings is easy, yeah. I bet it is. Black Knight Albert, of course. Time to watch Press suffer, yeah, exactly. Okay, so first equip the Abyss Ring. I'm going to leave the Fap Ring on. It's a good thing that we're not playing this run in November, because then the Fap Ring would not be allowed, but that's fortunately not the case, so let's preserve my Estus. You could not beat four kings with sorcery only? Did you not have enough castings or something like that? Of course, you could simply save them till after the DLC, and then you can just obliterate them with Darkbeat. Oh, by the way, how's the sound? I put the volume of my microphone down a little bit. I don't know exactly how sensitive the volume knob of the microphone is, but... at least you can still hear the ASMR of me slurping my coffee, but... I did a challenge run using glitches where I managed to kill four kings as the second boss on a fresh character. Ah. Well, technically, I could have... on a fresh character, okay. Technically, I could have done that in this playthrough too, because I started actually with Sif as the first boss in this run. So... it is possible, at least. Oh boy, now, there we go. Okay, I don't have the... Pyromancy Flame equipped, so I should do that. And... do we need something else? No, I have... and I don't have, like, a Divine Blessing in... well, then again, I don't need that, because... that takes as much time as popping humanity, I think, so... sounds okay, but I'm hearing a weird accent over your voice. A weird accent over your voice? Yeah, I have a weird accent, I know. As long as it's not a microphone malfunction, but I don't think that the microphone can really add an accent. That would be interesting, but yeah. You've done one where you kill Priscilla as your first boss? Oh, that requires a lot of glitches to get all the way over there. Alright, there we go. Well, at least Power Within gives me a stamina regen boost. So that's something at least. Oh boy. Don't throw magic, don't throw magic. Ooh. Oh fuck, they still hit me. Well, at least when I'm near the hilt, I can at least tank the hits, but... oh, fuck! Oh, that's a problem. Poise, poise, help me, poise. Oh, shit, poise did not completely help me. Oh, the second one's already there. Ah, fuck, I don't... oh! I don't want to get stuck in these healing loops. The magic attack definitely gets me in a healing loop. Oh, wait, that still hit me. Yeah. Uh-oh. How do I dodge the... oh, damn it, that doesn't work when you're this slow. I kind of was afraid of that. Okay, quickly heal. Already halfway through my Estus, isn't that nice? Yeah, I don't know of any other way to handle that magic explosion than just heal through it. Whoa, that's what happens when you don't Arneel a Hilt. Yeah, same problem. Oh, whoa, fuck, no, I'm dead. Fuck. Yeah, see, that's the problem with not being able to win the DPS race. Then suddenly you have three kings at the same time. Oh boy. And I was already almost out of essence there. I guess I should have used the power within again, but yeah. Oh boy, oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Yeah, this is going to be a problem. Why don't you dodge? Well, because I'm trying to keep attacking, because if I constantly am dodging, then I don't have any chance to attack when I'm this slow. Hey, Bo Timbs. Hey, just joined the stream. And Tamsus, I just stumbled across your channel. Oh boy. So you're completely new to me, to my channel. Well, then you already get a taste of what to expect, I suppose. Red Tears Storm Ring puts power within, that is not even possible on 4 Kings. Well, I believe in the... wasn't that like in the very early versions of the Prepare to Die edition or something, that you could have a double curse? Something like that. But otherwise it's not possible, so... Could you block the AoE? Of course, I can't... How much magic resistance? 10. No. That's pointless. No, I don't watch Formula 1, James. I used to like 12 years ago or something. I don't know. No longer than that, probably. 15 years ago. Yeah, it's because you need the Artorias ring, exactly. So, Cursed and plus the Dust Crown ring. And then Red Tearstone Ring is then, it's not possible. So Red Tearstone Ring could be possible, but since I'm not will not be able to reliably dodge their attacks when I'm this slow, that's not going to help me. Basically, I need very good RNG. Well, at least I did get a good RNG in the sense that they did not throw magic. Because then I'm immediately fucked if they start to fight off that way. So, yeah, this is probably going to take a while. I sure as fuck hope that it will not take up the entire stream or even the majority of the stream, but it's definitely possible. No, it's an Iron Golem specific run, so I cannot wear any other armor, and I also cannot use any other weapon. I also cannot use a shield. So, yeah. There are basically no other ways to do this, I think. I'll just have to get quite lucky. And figure out how to avoid as much damage as I possibly can. While not having a good dodging ability. You can change armor, we won't switch. Snitch. Yeah, that's not exactly how it works. If your character has 10 fingers, why is the ring limit only 4? That's actually only 2 in this game. In Dark Souls 2 and 3, you can wear 4 rings. That's true. But you only have 2 ring fingers, so 2 makes sense in that sense. Okay. There we go again. I haven't done any type of specific boss only run because that requires a mod, so it's not possible. That's a PC thing. Are you going to be making a video for this? Now, I don't make videos for live streams. The only exception of that was when I did the no-hit run for Bloodborne. All right. Oh, shit. I actually should have... I should first have dropped down and then used it, but... Yeah. That was stupid. Okay, don't throw magic. Don't throw magic, please. Oh fuck, the grab. Yeah, that doesn't work. That doesn't work if you're so slow. God damn it, I don't know what to do with the grab now. Because my usual tactic doesn't work. No, that's not a good start. Well, I do have poise, but I don't have that much poise. Fuck. Heal quick! I didn't heal. I wasn't... Damn it, I was still in attack animation. Yeah. Didn't you used to make philosophy videos? That was a very long time ago. It was like 8 years ago that I stopped doing that. Doesn't Iron Golem Weapon have a very strong R2? No. No, it doesn't. You do have this. You have the special attack, this. But since I try to get as close as possible, that doesn't help me. And this attack is very slow and it doesn't really do that much more damage than the... than the normal R1s. Basically, getting two R1s in is better than getting one R2 in. Sifrun is just to give the controller to your dog and hope for the best. Of course. Do you like anime? It's been a long time since I specifically watched any. Steel ring or lingering help ring won't help. It won't be better than the Fab Ring. I mean, the Fab Ring gives me more stamina, especially that more stamina is so important because I will be constantly out of stamina. And it gives me a health boost, so I don't see how Ring of Steel Protection would be better. Oh, step on elevator after going down. You're absolutely right. I forgot to do that. Well, the one good thing is that I don't have to defeat the four kings yet. So if it takes so long, I can, of course, go somewhere else. But of course, at some point, I will have to defeat them. So, wait, is the Estus Flask addictive to undead? Oh, ow, that's nice. Oh, fuck. Oh. Ah. This time I can't even make it to the boss. Okay. Now when I go down the elevator, I definitely need to step on it. Otherwise, it's going to take too long. Oh, where are the mods? That's a good point. I actually need to appoint more mod raiders, I guess. Because the two appointed mod raiders are not in the chat at the moment. Use Havel and don't fat roll. Yeah. No. Use Havel Rings, that allowed? No, because that makes me mid-roll. And the whole point of the run is fat rolling. Don't make me one, I'll go drunk with power instantly. Well, Isada Potato, you say that, but you actually wanted to invade me, so maybe you don't have my best interest in mind. Yeah, and Shmoku says, I can be mod, but don't trust me. Yeah, that's very clear. I don't see Moody Bastard yet. He's also someone who's usually here. So I could make him a moderator. This must be a painful run. Well, this is the... Well, we actually had already some problems with the gargles in part one, so that already sets the mood for the rest of the run, but Once in the snow, we're not as bad, I must say. We went through that relatively smoothly. So this is the first major hurdle, but of course, once we make it past the four kings... God damn it! I can't even get past these fucking ghosts! But once we make it past the four kings, then eventually we're going to reach the DLC. And I suspect that all four DLC bosses are going to be a major problem. A major problem. Even the Sanctuary Guardian, when he does his four lightning orbs quickly in a row. I'm not even sure how I'm going to be able to handle that. And the true Dark Souls 1 enjoyer playing with 100% weight. Yeah, then I guess I'm not a true Dark Souls enjoyer, because I'm not going to do that. It would kind of mimic how the Iron Golem walks, because the boss version basically can only walk and not even do this mild jog that I'm doing. I could actually start off with the Red Tearstone Ring, but yeah. Not going to. You should just not get hit. Yeah, but that's kind of tough to do when you cannot really reliably dodge their attacks. Can someone invade you if you are in a different NG? Yes. Yes, you can. How many parts do you expect the series to be? I have no idea. I have no idea. It completely depends on this fight and on the DLC. Other than that, I think it's going to be... Hey, good luck. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. Other than that, I think it's going to be okay. Did you do a no-hit run for DS1? No, I only did for Bloodborne. Alright, let's go. Yeah, by running sideways. Yeah, not when you're this slow, Captain Morgan. That's my whole point. Okay, that's some good RNG at least. Damn it, I should actually attack once, but yeah. Of course, I didn't want to have the same problem as in the previous attempt. Okay. I actually could have still attacked him when he was in his death animation. Okay, quick heal. Oh fuck, now he does it again. Oh fuck. Yeah, I don't know how to avoid that when I'm this slow. Because my usual technique doesn't work and I'm dead, fuck. Okay, that's a problem. I don't know how to avoid the grab when fat rolling. Because normally, if you are familiar with my other Dark Souls videos, you know how I always avoid the grab attack. And that's evidently not possible when you're this slow. Resin could help a bit, maybe. That's not possible. You cannot buff the Golem Axe. Hello, Kevin. BOC. BOC? Slow federal rolling will be fun. I don't know what BOC stands for. Just walk away? From the grab? No, not from the... You can't walk away from the grab. When you are... When you can fast roll, the way you can avoid the grab is by running away or rolling away three times, actually, is... It's usually enough if you do it quickly enough, but that's not the case, of course, when you're fat rolling. No, you can't do that. You can't do that because I'm using Power Within So I cannot use the green grass. What's the name of it? What is it? Green blossom. Yeah, you cannot use that. Oh, I step on the elevator. I forgot it again. Yeah, you're completely correct. Oh, Bat of Chaos, of course. Yeah, that's also going to be fun, yeah. I think you can run past the grab attack, but you need stamina. Was that the issue? Not sure, actually. Hey, Bushy Potato, you finished DS2 SL1 just in time for this stream. Well, well done then. With or without stat boosting gear? I hope for your sake with stat boosting gear. Okay, this is more effective way to avoid these ghosts now, by the way. Yo, good luck on the run from your southern neighbors. Oh, you're Belgium. Thanks for all the fun content. Well, you're very welcome. Yeah, and Power Within is better for stamina regen than Green Blossom. But the point is you cannot stack them. In fact, Green Blossom is a way to tell when Power Within has run out when you're stacking it with the Red Tearstone Ring. Because then the visuals are getting overridden by the RTSR effect. Without stat boosting this time, oh boy. And did you have fun? Because that is painful. And you know that I know that from experience. Yeah, we have two potatoes in the stream now. Well, boiled potatoes is very Dutch, so I guess that's only fitting. Two taters, exactly. Can't you stack Power Within and Iron Flesh and just heal through the attacks while smacking four kings? I don't have Iron Flesh, I think. Do I have Iron Flesh? I don't have it. I don't actually. To be fair, I actually don't even know where you can find it in the game. Hey, Gaming Balls. You're from Russia. Ah. What will happen after BG plus 6? I think you mean NG plus 6. Well, then you go to NG plus 7, but given that the difficulty caps at Nukem plus 6, NG plus 7 is basically just the same thing. Are you allowed to use a bow to aim firebombs in this run? I haven't even considered that. I'm probably not going to do that. So yeah, Battle of Chaos is going to be a whole bunch of fun. Fart rolling. Okay, well there we go. Oh boy, I really hope I don't have to spend the entire stream doing this shit, but... Okay, that's one. At least that was good RNG, because the second one is only just barely showed up. Oh fuck, no, heal! Oh, I didn't heal! I couldn't heal in time! Shit, okay, now even if I survive, Power Within is going to kill me. Doesn't even matter. Damn it. Yeah, it was going pretty well, but until that grab, of course. Are you Dutch? Yes, I am. And good morning, RSK. If a challenger Andy can spend 20 plus hours of streaming Gale at base level, I'm sure you can do this 500 hour stream. Well, it's not that I can't do it, it's just more that I hope that you guys don't get bored. Well, then again, all the people watching Challenger Andy don't get bored, so I guess I don't have to worry about that. Yeah, the run was good so far, but then the grab and I couldn't heal in time, so... I cannot eat grass, Tarek. That doesn't work, you cannot stack that with Power Within. Okay, this time I have to step on the elevator. Oh, hey, Agony in the chat! Yay! Also, Agony in the game, but that's a different kind of Agony. And now we have Kira. One of my two fangirls. Just roll for bed of bullshit. Trying to get through the hands in the third phase. That not even sure yet how I'm going to do that, but maybe my poise can save me. I don't know. Am I one of your fangirls? Yeah. You're like a fangirl, Hisato. Is Grass Bell and Power Within? No, it's not. Oh, you've run out of Italian stuff to do, Agony, so that's why you're here. I completely understand that. You know, doing hits and that kind of stuff, you know, for the mafia. I mean, that's what Italian people do. Either you're baking a pizza or you're working for the mafia. That's basically Italian culture, I guess. Hey, my first run, Four Kings, were the first boss I actually had trouble with. After DS2 and 3, it was a breath, but this boss, so fucking hard to judge the distance. Yeah, I know what you mean. Half of the attacks should have connected, just miscast reasons. Or the other way around. Can you escape the grab before taking damage? No. No in between mafia or pizza. Yeah, or pasta. Of course, spaghetti. That's also possible, but something along those lines. Sir Alon, the most difficult boss I ever faced. Well, it's the boss I had to give up on when I did my SL1 Nukem plus 7 Broken Straight Sword without stat boosting gear run. Oh, I forgot to step on the elevator again. You're completely right. I have a terrible memory. Or I could just blame you guys. You guys are distracting me. You know, chatting and such. Damn. The hardest boss in my opinion is Madeir. Well, initially yes, but when you, once you figure out how that fight works, it's a very consistent and actually pretty fair fight. Except maybe for the Dark Tracers at some point they can be a little unfair, but for the rest, it's a very consistent, well designed fight. Okay, now, there goes the next attempt. Well, so far they still haven't thrown magic, so at least that is something to be very happy with. Oh fuck! Humanity inquiry. Okay, well, it also heals me, so. Whoa, fuck! What the hell? Oh yeah, that was not a healed hit. Jesus. Well, that was hard to tell. Maybe I should not play with lock on. Maybe that would help. Okay, well that was shit. But that's weird. I was standing. I was pressed up against him, but it still was not a healed hit. So, yeah, shame. It may also have been... I didn't pay attention exactly when I got hit, but it may also have been a counter hit, but... basically, the way that their swords are designed, which is kind of weird, by the way, but... when you are pressed up against the boss, then it's, I guess the logic behind is that they hit you with the hilt of their sword, or something like that. Again, it's a bit weird. Okay, this time I have to stand on the button of the elevator. But then you take reduced damage. So if you're pressed up against the boss, then when they do the sideways attacks, especially, but also the stab can also work. Then they hit you with the hilt, and then you take reduced damage. However, if you get hit by the blade, then it's a different story, because a nuke plus 6, that will do massive damage, as you saw. Oh, did I stand on the elevator now? I don't even remember. See how bad my memory is? Weapon art from a distance, yeah, but the problem is that weapon art does actually very little damage. And I cannot really stay at a distance anyway, so, because then, of course, when I get hit by the sword, it will be a blade hit, and I will take massive damage, so I don't think that's going to work. The only way that the weapon art could work is if I could get away from the AoE, and then I could hit him from a distance with the wind attack, but given that I can't even get away from that AoE in the first place, it's not going to help me anyway. Hey, we have a baguette in the chat. So we have a French person. I mean, I suppose it's a French person. Yeah, that's actually a good point, Smoker. When you hit... when you use R2, so the special attack, if you're pressed up against an enemy, you also hit them still with the axe. So you basically have a double hitbox. But then again, I constantly try to hit them with R1s when two-handing, so yeah. Because the wind attack is quite slow, so basically I could get in two-handed R1s in that time. So yeah, I'm not sure about that. Potatoes are better than baguettes. Well, there we go again. At least so far I'm getting good RNG at the start when not throwing magic. Of course, now I said that out loud, they are going to throw magic. Which probably means that I'm immediately fucked. Well, that's also a magic attack, but that's not... Oh, that is the... I dodged way too early. Oh, there's the... Okay, now, I'm immediately dead. That's very bad RNG, and now Power Within is going to kill me. Yeah. Crapalicious. Okay, if they start like that, that's also not gonna work. Shit. Oh boy, this is... yeah, this is quite an obstacle, this fight. This is quite an obstacle. If you're one-shot anyway, maybe try Red Tearstone Ring. Well, I'm not one-shotted by everything. Actually, I can tank through quite a bit of attacks, actually. As I said, as long as they hit me with the hilt of the sword, I can take quite a few hits. So I don't see how Red Tearstone Ring is going to help me. At best, what I could do is no Red Tearstone Ring is off the table to begin with. Otherwise, I have to break the Fab Ring. I do have two more, but still. After all, I need to wear the Artorias ring. Any tips on how to enjoy DS2? Well, if you can't even enjoy it, then my tip is to simply not play the game. If you don't enjoy it, then you shouldn't play it. Four kings are worse than Bed of Chaos. In this run, that might actually be the case, but of course, I don't know yet how hard it's going to be to get through the hand swipes in the third phase. After all, for the first and second phase, I can. Well, damn it! Now I'm thinking about the second, breaking the second thing. Then I will have to jump the gap because I cannot use my usual bow strategy. So. And yeah, and doing the firebomb trick. Yeah, I'm not so sure about that one. First of all, I would actually have to have the screenshots available because I. Yeah, otherwise, I will probably not be able to do it. Yeah, I don't see RTSR as a solution with fat rolling either. I don't think that's going to help me. Because then, for the entire fight, I would have to consistently dodge everything while being absolutely slow as fuck. I don't see that happening. If you swap DS2 and DS1 around Julkin Juice, or whatever, then that's my would be my list. So Dark Souls 1 is actually your least favorite, oh boy. Still can't believe you did Broken Strange on DS2, NG+, 7, SL1, and without stat boosting gear, remember that one, because that is what made that run so ridiculously hard. Are you max level? I'm level 200. Max level is like, what, level 700 or something? I don't know. Of course, there's not that much difference between this and max level, but yeah. I would say that Lawrence is more difficult than Orphan of Chaos. Of course, Orphan of Chaos is also a very difficult boss. No doubt about that. Is this an old character of yours? Yes. And there we go again. Oh fuck, now they do the actual magic throw. Well, that's not a good start. I don't have as much poise as I thought I would have. They do quite a bit of poise damage. Oh, there's the second king already. Jesus. Oh fuck, that was a hilt. That was not a hit. That was a blade hit. You see the difference between blade and hilt hits? I would say they are quite noticeable. Oh shit, I'm locked on. I shouldn't do that. Oh fuck, ah crap. Yeah, see, oh fuck, why is he so far away?
Damn it, yes. It doesn't work. It doesn't work when you are... when you federal. It doesn't work. Damn it. Quickly. Get up and heal. Heal! Again! Oh, whoa! Actually avoided it. No, don't throw magic! What the fuck? Are you kidding me? Oh my god, I couldn't finish it. And now the magic is out. Oh my god, this is fucked. Oh, and again! Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Oh, that was... Are you kidding me? That was ridiculous. Oh my god. Oh. That... Wow. That... Wow. Un-fucking believable. That was... I don't even have a soul, but that hurt my soul. That it just... Two magic attacks in a row while I was only one hit away. And I couldn't hit him in his death animation anymore because I was out of stamina. That was just beyond bad RNG. Even though the rest of the fight was great RNG. The rest of the fight, the RNG was really good. Oh my god. That was just beyond painful. Come on. Yeah, that was absolutely ridiculous. Well. Mate, what part of the Netherlands are you from? Well, I am not going to give my exact address, of course, but I'm from the south. So, that... maybe actually you can actually hear that from my accent. There are a very few times in my videos, like in my recent video, where I actually spoke a little bit of Dutch. And from my accent, you could probably tell that I'm from the south. Yeah, does Kraska's shield violate the rules of the run? Yeah, I'm not going to use it. I'm not going to equip a shield. Iron Golem doesn't have a shield, so no. Not going to do that. How you dodge the grab? Well, I still don't even know exactly how I did it, but I think what I did is when the actual grab came out, I dodged sideways and... Based on my positioning, that actually worked. Ugh, goddammit, but that was so fucking painful. Yeah, okay, Iron Golem does have a Pyro Flame Eater. Yeah, in that sense, you're correct. Well, no, Hisato, because I make the rules, so if I say Pyro Flame, then yes, Pyro Flame. But I'm not going to use actual Pyromancers, of course, it's only Pyro Within, because that's the only buff I can use, because the Golem Axe cannot be buffed, so... No, Heaven's Ring is not allowed, because that removes my Fat Rolling. Iron Golem also has a grab attack, yeah, but you don't have a grab attack in this game other than the Dark Hand. Why not stack some stamina broccoli? Because you can't. You cannot use that when Power Within is active. How do you have two casts? Well, I didn't pick up a third one, but I actually could even have three. But then again, I haven't even used the second one. Yeah, you can use the Dark Hand for the grab move, but how many enemies can you even use the Dark Hand on? Okay. Oh my god, I just can't believe what happened in the previous attempt. Jesus. That was absolutely ridiculous. Oh. Oh, nice start. Oh, are you kidding me? So now I'm way too slow. The other one has already shown up. Oh fuck. Nope, it didn't work this time. I was not in the right position. So, I'm probably already fucked because it's taking way too long. I mean, this is still only the first one. Oh, I couldn't even see that coming. You see, that's the problem. That's the DPS part of the fight. Huh. Oh, hey, Bia shown up, the one of my moderators. What are the stats? I'm level 200. If you hit two of them, you do double damage. You cannot hit two of them. I mean, I guess maybe there's some way, but no, not like this. Oh, I really wish that my previous attempt simply would have been successful. But just those two magic attacks, I mean, it's just unbelievable that those happened. And of course, in this attempt, two magic AoEs at the same time. Dixac run, exactly. Where did you get the idea of this video? I don't know, actually. I have no idea where I got it from. I just like the Iron Golem armor, and I was like, yeah, and I've never done a fat rolling run, so, yeah, why the hell not? Well, this boss, that's why the hell you would not want to do this, but yeah. Yeah, so I'm level 200, and these are my stats, so basically what you would expect, I guess. Have you ever played as a Sunbro? I probably have at some point, but I basically never do multiplayer. Super underrated channel. Good luck, Press. Thank you so much, Lollipop Lord. The Lord of Lollipops. Firekeeper run. How to beat without walking. Oh yeah, this game's Firekeeper, yes. And of course, DS3... Firekeeper run would be without looking at, without, you know, with your eyes closed. Are you gonna make a part 3? Well, yeah. I mean, I'm not going to be able to beat the game this particular stream. So there will definitely be a part 3. Probably also a part 4. Maybe a part 5, who knows. More than 40 vid would help, though. Yeah, that's true, but... I'm not going to be able to level up when I need like 300,000 souls for the next level. DS3 no feat, man. Iron Golem armor is not upgradable, I think. I'm pretty sure it's not. We talked about it in the previous stream as well, and I think it's not. You cannot upgrade it. Te veel Doritos gegeten. Heb je helemaal gelijk in. Are you going to do a no bonfire stream one day? I already did a no death no bonfire run for this game, so it's already on my channel. Hey, Iriam? Why do you guys always have these hard to pronounce names? That's very annoying. Like Bushy Potato, I can at least pronounce it. But there are so many people, I'm just not sure how to pronounce your names. My favorite part about your channel is seeing how bad Dutch humor translates to English, and it makes it so much more funny. Hisato. Yeah, Hisato is easy. Or maybe I'm mispronouncing it, who knows. Yeah, Shimoko Fuji Warrior. Oh, and there we have our other moderator, Ismail. Well, unfortunately, we didn't have any bots yet, so that's... it's pronounced Irium. Okay. Oh, you're German. Oh, I see. Komt goed, gabber. All right, there we go again. Who knows how long this is going to take? Oh fuck. There we go again. I basically have to tank it. Oh, and then of course with a blade hit. Yeah, that's nice. Basically, if the first king takes too much time, I actually avoid it, then it's basically already over. So it's probably already over now. See, there's the second king already. So unless I get really good RNG now. Ooh, powered in. Ah, oh, powered in killed me. Oh, damn it, that magic does so much damage. But yeah, I still don't think that I can even avoid it. And by the way, it also takes too much time anyway, so. It just sucks so much that what is now 3 attempts ago, that one was just so fucking painful. God, YouTube never notifies shit. Yeah, exactly. I actually recently was thinking, hey, that particular guy didn't upload in a few days. How is that possible? And then I noticed that I was unsubscribed, even though I didn't unsubscribe to him. So that's also a weird thing that can happen. Try to pronounce my name, good luck. Gustavo Aleatorio. I don't know. Waarom probeer je niet te rollen bij die explosie? Omdat je niet door die explosie heen kan rollen. You can't iframe the AoE explosion, so... You have to completely get out of that, and by the way, when you're fat rolling, you have less iframes, so... Then it would definitely not work. Well, first of all, I'm not even sure if I have the Sanctus, but... if I'm not equipping the Kraska shield, I'm also not equipping the Sanctus. By the way, the Sanctus heals very slowly, so it's... In fact, it won't even prevent Power Within from killing you. Of course, it will go down a little bit slower, but still. Hey, already was pointed out, it's not like the Iron Golem has a Pyromancy Flame either, so. So, the only thing other than the normal Iron Golem setup is Power Within, and other than that, I'm not going to equip anything else. Can you please make a face reveal? Yeah, I'm not so sure about that yet. I mean, having some sort of privacy on the internet is also always a good thing. I have not done DLC yet at this point, Baiku Nicholas. No, the axe is not buffable, no. And we'll keep it a secret. there's practically no one who even knows that I have a YouTube channel in my actual life. And the ones who do know don't know what my channel name is. So. Now, as I said, Alexander, I'm only using Power Within and nothing else. I don't know if you can handle his voice and his face. No, you will not. You will not. You're probably so hot. Yeah, that absolutely. That's also another reason why I don't want people to see my face, because then they will then they will start objectifying me and such. Ah, okay. Well, we have a shitty start again. And of course, a blade hit. Yeah, I can't have a start like this, because if it takes too long to kill the first king, then the whole DPS race thing gets in the way. There's the second king already. Oh, come on. Unfucking believable. Oh, fuck. Oh my god. Yeah, you can't run away from that. Okay, this attempt is not going to be it. Absolutely not. Yeah, oh, whoa, and that was another blade hit. Jesus fuck, dude. Oh my god. If only that one run, you know, the one that, of course, the people who've just joined a few minutes ago don't know what I'm talking about, but the ones who have seen the entire, all the attempts, know what I'm talking about. If that one went through, then, yeah, this fight would have been over, but, yeah. I'll probably won't get that same RNG again. Komt goed, kabbertje. Have you played Cuphead? Oh, that's been years ago. That was even before I had my channel. But yes, I have played Cuphead. It's a good game. That's a really good game. Do you prefer the kindling mechanics or the Essence Flash shards? I haven't even really considered that. I actually kind of like the idea of Essence Flash shards, that you have to collect your Essence Flash. But of course, in this game, you have the Rite of Kindling that prevents you from immediately starting off with 20 Essence Flash. After 69 attempts, you get good RNG. I've seen your Bloodborne No Hunter's Dream run. Good job on that one, was really cool. Yeah, I the only thing about that run is that I wish I actually would have done that like this year or something. Of course, now I've already done a No Hits run. But if you've seen my No Hit run, then you know that I by now am using way better strategies and all. I use actually pretty shitty strategies in my No Hunter's Dream run. Which is one of the reasons why it took so many attempts, because I use way too many YOLO strats, way too many there were way too many times where I didn't have a good way to take bad RNG into account and that sort of kind of thing. I didn't even make good uses of blue elixirs and such. So that run was basically just the end result of just throwing yourself against the game again and again until you finally made it through. And even then I messed up a whole bunch of times. Like, if I remember correctly, of course it's been very long since I even watched that video. I can't even watch that video back because I cringe too much from the commentary. My first year my commentary was so fucking monotone. But for example, against the Bloodstarved Beast, for some reason I completely messed up the corner trick. Of course, doing one of my no-hit-run attempts, I also completely messed that up, so I guess I simply have a habit of doing that. But yeah, it is my most popular video, at least. What's your favorite Soulsborne game? That would be Bloodborne. Oh god. So that's basically how if... Okay, and I tried to dodge and it didn't even work. So it's... It sucks so much that if you already know at the start of the attempt that you're basically already going to fail. Because you simply don't have the right RNG. Oh, okay, another blade hit. Okay, now I need phenomenal RNG. And I don't get that. Ah, fuck, he pushed me away. Or I actually moved out of the way, whatever. Oh, fuck. Oh, I didn't see that coming. Heal. Oh, come on. That is some fuck. Oh my god! Oh, he's dead. Okay, that was pretty lucky. Why is he all the way over there? Jesus, fuck, dude. Okay, well, that was good at least. I guess I should have used a second power then, but... Come on, this should be possible. I don't have stamina! Quick! No! Oh! Motherfucker! I did not expect that this would be the successful attempt. But with that shitty start. But, well, I did say that I needed phenomenal good RNG and... It was, well, maybe not phenomenal, but it was sufficient at least. Jesus, motherfucker. God fucking fuck the fucking fuck up the fucking fuck. Oh, oh well, yeah. Well, no, first try, nice. God fucking damn it. Yeah. Well, we at least made it through that and in only about an hour. Yeah, a little more. Jesus, motherfucker. Every enemy in this run is like a tree, they all fall after some axing. Yeah, that's basically do. Well, I'm Lumberjackalin, so... Ik zei toch dat het goed ging komen, Gabber. Oh, damn it, I'm spilling water all over my controller. That's not good. An hour and 10 minutes, exactly. First try. Yeah, we'll just call that first try. Gritty Orange, so we have a German. Grüße und die Niederlande. Ja, dat is een welkom hier in de stream. De donkere zielen spelen of something, I don't know. I really failed at German when I was in high school, so 87 attempts, but still first try. Exactly. So, but hey, we still haven't had the most painful part of the playthrough, because that would be the DLC. Imagine doing Artorias, oh, or Calamite, Jesus. Yeah, the DLC bosses are going to be horrible. This is on PS5. Of course, it's a PS4 version, but yeah, it's on PS5. Well, by the way, I'm not... first of all, even with all the souls, I probably still don't have enough to level up, but I'm... Nah. Yeah, fuck it, I'm not going to level up anyway, yeah. But because someone mentioned I could still raise my vitality, you know, because it caps at 50. What's your poise? It's 86. Okay, so... oh, first of all, repair my stuff. So, let's go to Anolondo. Because then we're going towards the Duke's Archives, and we're going to... Oh, wait. No, no. That's not what we're going to do. Undead Parish, we're first going to kill the Hydra. No, I'm not... You know what? I'm just not going to level up. I mean, I'm level 200. That should be more than enough. Calamite, and you're vomiting. Yeah, probably when I'm doing that fight, I'll... I mean, we all know how fucked up Calamite's hitboxes are, and that's even with even when you have the flip ring, it can already be quite cancerous. So doing it fat rolling, that's going to be beyond cancerous. That's going to be super cancer. Bloodborne is the hardest game in the Soulsborne series. Not completely sure if I agree. I must say that BL4, you know, when it comes to the Soulsborne games without leveling, of course not counting Dark Souls 2 without stat boosting gear, but I would say that Blood Level 4 is the hardest no leveling run in the Soulsborne series, but I'm not quite sure if I would say that Bloodborne in general was the hardest. Bloodborne has the hardest skill curve, not really the hardest. Maybe that's a way to say it. In general, I would say that Dark Souls 3 is the hardest. At least by design, it's the hardest. It's designed to be the hardest Souls game. Of course, it doesn't necessarily have to be the case that you experience it like that. In fact, a lot of people base it solely on how they experience the game, which I don't think is really fair. I mean, that's like saying, well, I played the game when I was completely sick and I had a massive headache and I couldn't concentrate and I had a really hard time with the game, so that's the hardest game. You have to base it on more than just your direct personal experience, I would say. Dark Souls 3 is definitely designed to be the hardest. Oh, the Hydra, by the way, is going to be a pain in the dick as well without being able to block. And what I could do, by the way, first of all, I need to get rid of that... is approach it with a fork ring, then maybe I will not immediately get water to death. Have you ever done a calamity ring challenge? No, but I have done, of course, types of runs where you cannot get hit to begin with, like SL1 Nuka plus 7, Nuka plus 6, you know, same thing. The hardest is 1? No. I would say Dark Souls 1 is basically the easiest. Well, when it comes to boss fights, I would say that Dark Souls 2 is in general the easiest. Not all of them, of course, but... Dark Souls 1 is definitely not the hardest Souls game, absolutely not. At least I don't agree with that at all. I think for the final hats I need to use the wind attack, but... oh fuck, don't hit me. Oh fuck, the crystal golems are coming close. Huh? Ah, come on! What the fuck? Well, that was nice. Well, at least the Hydra can also kill the golems for me, but I hope that already... I kinda hope that already happened. The hardest Soulsborne is the one you played first? No, because Bloodborne was my first one, and I don't consider that one the hardest.
Verdammter Golem! Verdammt nochmal!
Really glad I found your channel a few months ago. You seem like a really cool guy. Well, thank you so much, Sideboy. I appreciate that. Personally, I found DS3 the easiest. Okay. But won't you agree that by design it's the hardest? I mean, in this game you don't even have multiple phase fights, for example. Is there anything the equivalent of like 3-day in this game? Because basically there isn't. You mean K&M, Lucas? That was my previous channel name, K&M Gaming Guides, which is not really a good channel name, so I'm glad I changed it. Which was short for my channel name I had back in... when did I delete it? I deleted it in 2016, I think, but I had it until I stopped uploading on in 2013, I think. Ah, whatever. Darsus 2 Skull of the First Sin Edition is the hardest. Yeah, it's the gankiest at least. In DS3, have you 1000 iframes. So you do have a lot more iframes, but that's basically... The roll is more effective because the game is a lot faster. So that's to compensate for that. So I wouldn't automatically say that it makes it easier, it's just that... goes with the flow of the game. Yeah, Battle of Chaos is technically a three-phase boss. I guess you could see it like that. But I mean, by design, they made bosses with multiple life bars in Dark Souls 3. So they made attacks specifically meant to roll catch you. They made sure that certain enemies are capable of defending behind themselves because of... the constant getting behind the boss type strategies in the previous games. It was definitely made to be the hardest Souls game. So whether you experience it like that is a different story, but... the simple fact of the matter is it was designed to be that way. Because there are clear design clues for that show that. But of course, the experience of difficulty is very subjective. Uh-oh, the golems are closing. Ah, no, don't kill me! Oh fuck, now I'm dead. Oh, I'm not dead. Oh, yeah, now I'm dead because of the water! Son of a whore! Okay, maybe I should approach this differently. I guess I should just approach the Hydra slowly so that I can first take out all the golems, because this is not gonna work like this. Damn, what the fuck is that damage? Yeah, that's the highest new game cycle, so that... Oh, fighting the two lesser Sanctuary Guards beyond Nukem Plus with any melee build is hard as well. Yeah, that's true. That's true. I actually think that Calamite is a bit harder than Manus, actually. At least I have more trouble with Calamite than Manus. Of course, Manus and Calamite are basically the hardest bosses in this game, so... they are close in difficulty, I would say. Okay, so I'm doing it different this time. I'm first going to kill to lure the golems towards me, then take them out. Otherwise, I'm constantly having issues with them approaching me, even with the fog ring. Manus kind of looks like he belongs in Bloodborne. Well, he is very beast-like. Try to get the New Game Plus 1000. It's a little too high, I would say. Manus is actually an easy boss. I wouldn't agree with that. I don't think he's easy. Damn it, Bush Potato, I get that question a lot, and then I look back at my videos, I'm like, oh, that's it, and then when I get asked the question, I already forgot. But let's just say it like this way, the hardest playthrough I've ever done in any game would not be in a Souls game. I would say, though, that the hardest run I did in a Souls game was probably my Dark Souls 2, SL1, Nuka Plus 7, Broken Straight Sword without stat boosting gear. And mainly because of the lack of stat boosting gear. Okay, so let's... Okay, they stagger after the third hit, that's good to know. Okay, that's one. I think I only need to take out this one. I don't think those two will approach me. So as long as the Hydra doesn't see me. Oh fuck, he does. Oh, that's not good. Okay, hopefully he cannot hit me here. Oh, whoa, that was actually quite close. Would be nice if the Hydra would actually kill that that golem for me. Oh, by the way, this is... Great from Software AI here. Yeah, walls and AI are not the strongest point when it comes to From Software from Software's design. I love From Software, but this is not what makes the game shine, I would say. Okay, that's good. Finally, I caught you live. Love your videos, Press. Thank you so much, Gabriel, and welcome to the stream. How long have you been playing Souls games? Since 2015. Do you expect much intelligence from Golem? Dude, I'm playing as the Iron Golem, so I don't know what you're trying to infer there, but that sounds a bit like. Like an underhanded comment. Okay, as long as there's really no golem. See, I was wrong. Okay, so I was wrong about that. The Hydra helps me. Oh, he does. Oh, fuck. Ah! Okay, quickly heal, otherwise I'm dead. Otherwise I'm dead. Yes. Great. Good. Okay. Okay, now no more golems following me. Yeah, the four kings are dead, Lord Alcatraz. So now I'm going to make my way towards the DLC. Hey, damn it, I'm constantly missing, that's not good. Of course, I have my ranged attack, so could make use of that as well, but... First, let's get rid of all the heads that are close to me. Running attack! Because I at least can still run.
All right, so now let's go to... Oh, by the way, I cannot block when I'm one-handing, so should watch out for that as well. Oh, there's still three ads left. It's a little hard to aim, but it does kind of work. Hey man, keep up the good work. Don't know how you're so good. Well, thank you. Try Augur of Darkness. The name rings a bell, but not sure exactly what it is. Damn it, I completely missed. And now I don't even see that. Maybe I should move a bit. Because they're constantly disappearing in the wall like this. Oh, he's actually close by. Okay, good. Only one more hat, and then... Yeah, it's only one hat. Okay, he's almost dead. Okay, good. Of course, now I still have to defeat the Gold Crystal Golem, which is going to be nice fat rolling through water. I wish my wood chopping axe would shoot out lasers. Well, it's actually more of a wind attack, actually. Did you ever play Ghost Runner? No. No, I have not. Actually, not even sure what game that is. Will you try a zero equip load in Dark Souls? Isn't that simply a consumable only run? Oh, why is it translucent? Because I have the fork ring equipped. Oh, by the way, that's... where do I have it? Will this help in the water? Because that might help when fighting the Gold Crystal Golem. Oh, Augur of Darkness is a DS2 mod. Ah, I see. Oh wait, I have to quit the game first before the Golem shows up. And Iron Golem is an airbender. Oh, Pyroflame... I thought the Pyroflame actually had weight in this game. Let me check, because I have the Pyroflame equipped after all. Yeah, okay, Ghost Runner is a parkour hack and slash game. I think I remember it. But I haven't played it, so... So let's take a look. Oh no, it's... Oh, wait. Okay, so zero equip load, you can simply do a pyro only run without wearing an armor set. So that's... It's not that interesting, I would say. I wonder if this one also staggers at the first... Yeah, yes, he does. Okay, that's good to know. Oh, ah, damn it. I wanted to finish it too beautifully. Oh, by the way, I can't simply do it like this. Oh, bah, I can't. Whoa, whoa, ooh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, now I'm just being stupid. I wanted to do it too beautifully. Yeah, now we have Dusk. Yeah, sorry, I don't want to listen to you yapping. Alright, so now we can go to Anolondo and then to the Duke's Archives, because then we can kill the Crystal Golem over there and get the key to the DLC, the Broken Pendant. Don't you get more iframes at zero equip? I don't think that your iframes increase. I actually don't think that's that the case, but I do believe that... When it comes to fast rolling, that when at zero equip load, you have a little tiny bit faster roll. I don't think if you can actually see it, but...
And now let's equip something. It's not really noticeable, but I believe it's actually, there is actually a difference between fast roll. So there is not only one specific fast roll, there's two or three, I believe. If you put it in YouTube search, you can probably find a video on it. Okay, now let's go to Analando. I love how she just kind of appears. I believe that was it Zully the Witch? I think Zully the Witch was it, or someone else who actually showed that she is specifically hidden inside the Crystal Golem. So she doesn't just spawn out of nowhere, she is actually inside of it. Each roll has three sub-rolls, including fat rolls. Is that really the case? Huh. Whenever I play Dark Souls 1, I don't press continue, I press load... Ah, you should always press continue. Shame on you. I do know that at zero equip you run faster. Okay, that's actually... Oh, and faster recovery frames? Interesting. Do you think Pyro in DS1 is broken? I wouldn't say broken, it can be very good, if that's what you mean. But it also takes a shit ton of souls, so to upgrade an Ascended Pyro Flame... what is it, like 500,000 souls or something? Heb je een SL run gedaan, SL1 run gedaan in DS3? Ik ben daar nou mee bezig en ik kom niet langs het... I have. It's kind of outdated because it's very old. And given that you're already in the DLC... I have done SL1 Nukem Plus 7 in Dark Souls 3, but only the main game. So the video I made on the DLC bosses is from over 3 years ago, so it's a little bit outdated, I would say. But it might still be of help, so you can check it out. Did you hear about the Cuphead challenge for DS3? No. Was that like using Farron Dart or something? My friend told me Source in DS1 is balanced. Yeah, especially Dark Beat is very balanced. Yeah, I think Pyro Plus 15 takes 500,000 souls or something. You can look it up. It's a shit ton at least. Because even when you do SL1, but you don't use any sort of souls for leveling up, then you still have to go out of your way to actually get enough souls to actually upgrade your Pyro Flame to max. DS3 Nukem 7 fist only ringless fighting with deer. Maybe. Why ringless? No, not ringless. Oh, it's 340,500 souls for full upgrade. And of course, you still have to spend souls on buying pyromancies, of course. Oh boy, how am I going to get... I cannot roll past them after all, so... Yeah. Come along with me. I have to make sure that I don't get directly behind him, because... Oh, fuck. Oh, now he can't hit me. Good. Because then he can kick, after all. I should have equipped the stamina ring again, but... Okay, so let's equip the stamina ring now. Because the Iron Golem set... also decreases your stamina regen, so that's why the stamina ring is very helpful with this armor set on. Slice up some bacon press. Well, it was still in its packaging, so that was a bit of an issue. Rules, basically I'm cosplaying as the Iron Golem and I have to fat roll, so I cannot wear Havel's ring. That's basically the only rule. And I don't want to use things that are not... that don't fit with the Iron Golem, so no sorceries or that kind of stuff. I only use Power Within because I cannot buff my axe. And I actually only have used it so far on the Four Kings, and that was of course very understandable. We'll build the hardest boss while we just defeated the Four Kings, and that already took over an hour. But, this armored boar here, that will be the hardest boss. Definitely. Definitely. That will be the hardest boss fight. Jesus, fuck. That's kind of sucked. It's kind of sucked that he's around the corner there, because I first have to lure him around the corner before I can get behind him. Yeah. That was a one boar stampede. Welcome to Nukem Plus 6. So that's another thing about this run, is that not only am I fat rolling, but on Nukem Plus 6 your armor doesn't really do that much anymore. So the Iron Golem set in principle is a pretty decent armor set. It has high physical defenses. Of course the lightning defenses are absolutely abysmal. But the physical defenses are very good. However, on Nukem Plus 6, as you can see, yeah, doesn't really work that well. What is your favorite kind of build? Usually I don't really do builds, because most of my runs are like SL1 or something, so you can't really call that a build after all. Can you upgrade your armor? No, it's not. The Iron Golem set cannot be upgraded. Unfortunately, I have to go. Good luck on your run. Well, thank you for being here, Alexander. And since there will guaranteed be a part 3, hopefully I will see you the next time, which will be next Thursday, by the way. So it's the same as this week, but then if there's going to be a part 4, which again, also very likely, that will then be next Sunday. The most fun build is the build where you can use everything, so that's the opposite of SL1. Okay, let's pick up my zero souls. Oh, no, it's not zero, but whatever. Okay, how am I going to... Can I hit him just around the corner? Actually, I can. Okay, that works. Oh, fuck, that doesn't work. Okay, as long as I can now stay... near his hind leg, that should be fine. I do have to say that in this game, the stamina ring actually does something. Because to be honest, in Dark Souls 3, the difference between not wearing the Chlorinity ring and wearing it is not actually all that noticeable. And the difference between the normal Chlorinity ring and the Chlorinity plus 3 is also not even that all that noticeable. Can you use magic when you need and melee in sticky... What? Oh, that was in reference to something else. Egghead stream when? I'm not so sure about that. How many bosses are left in this run? Well, we only have one great soul so far, namely from the Four Kings. So, Sif is still left, Battle of Chaos is still left, and of course the bosses along the way towards the Battle of Chaos also. Graveful Nido is still left, and therefore also Pinwheel. And of course the DLC bosses. Okay, maybe I should actually keep watching the screen when I'm talking. I killed some of the optional bosses, namely the Moon Butterfly and Capra Demon. Gwendolyn is still alive at least. Gaping Dragon is still alive. Yeah, the DLC bosses, so... Oh, Priscilla. Priscilla's also still alive. Yeah, it's actually a common thing that I get hit while looking at the stream. Oh, Brutox! Oh my god, how did I miss the stream? Yeah, you didn't set an alarm clock, I think, Brutox. Because you can't rely on YouTube sending you a notification, unfortunately.
The Tomb of Giants will be fun. Oh yeah, getting past the giant skeletons. Okay, that's also nice, yeah. Well, at least I can equip the Skull Lantern to have light. That I can do. Almost got you killed, whoops. Well, you wouldn't be the first one. And of course, it's my fault for not looking at the screen. Are you going to try to do all bosses then? Well, what I was thinking about is like saving Gaping Dragon, Priscilla, and Gwynnon for last, and only do that if I have time. So it's possible that I will skip those three bosses. It just depends because I need to fit in these streams in these blocks of 4 hours after all. So that depends. Oh fuck! Ooh. Oh fucking buffed. That's what I mean. Get out of here. These backstabbing works. And Gaping Priscilla. Holy crap, that's a lot of damage. Okay. You always get notifications on mobile. So is this like a difference? On mobile and on desktop. DS1 Clarity Ring plus 20 stamina per second. And DS3 plus 3 ring is 10 per second. Yeah, exactly. So basically in DS3, most rings aren't that effective to begin with. In this game, they are definitely a lot better. Of course, the Red Tearstone Ring is arguably a little overpowered even, but... In Dark Souls 3, the Red Tearstone Ring is also not all that great. Okay, now let's watch out for the channeler. Uh-oh. Ah, here we... Ah, no. Oh. Well, that sucked. Damn it, I have to get past here again to even reach that crystal golem. Actually, I should have hit it from a distance with the wind attack. I didn't even consider that. So I can lure him over to me. My favorite armor is Marvelous Chester. High bleed resist plus decent resistance plus bloodborne look. Yeah, exactly. Hey, he is from a different world, so in your headcanon you could say that he is from the world of Bloodborne. Of course, they hadn't even started designing that world back then, I assume. That's just an excuse to skip most dangerous bosses. Yeah, like Gaping Dragon, Priscilla and Gwendolyn? Yeah, I wouldn't say so. Well, Gwendolyn might be a little bit of an issue, actually, when you're this slow. But we'll see if there's time left. Of course... The bosses that really matter are the DLC bosses, and we are definitely going to do those. And they are probably going to take a lot of time. Oh, they actually started working on Bloodborne during the production of the DLC? Wow. Then there was quite a bit of production time for Bloodborne, given that it only released in 2015. Okay, Agony has to go. Well, thank you for being here, and good luck with doing more Italian stuff. The creator was working on Bloodborne while making the DLC, so the DLC bosses look like Bloodborne bosses a bit. Oh, okay. Was not aware of that. Ah, fuck. Oh, and the wind attack doesn't even connect. Yeah, the annoying thing about the wind attack is that you aim very low, so you very easily hit the floor, for example. Or in this case, the stairs. Well, that's a good thing that backstabs have iframes in this game. Very good thing. Ah, fuck, but that was at the end of my iframes. Okay, this time let's use the wind attack on the golem. Oh, fuck. Ah, that's not good. Oh, I don't have... Ah, shit. That's not good. Okay, let's get out of here. I don't have my repair powders equipped.
Oh, he's not going to leave me alone. Okay, this kind of sucks. So I do reduce damage now. Yeah, that's definitely quite a bit less damage. Okay, now he will stagger. Yes. Okay, that should be doable. Oh, hey, they didn't stagger now the third time. That's some fuck. Alright, now let's equip my repair partners again. Oh, okay. Let's use it. I actually want to equip them. How does Calamite look like a Bloodborne boss? Yeah, that definitely does not look like a Bloodborne boss. Wind attacks work best if you turn around. Get what I mean? Brutox! Don't be so juvenile. I would never make jokes like that. Poopa. DS3 base quarantine ring is +7 stamina per second versus the +10 from the +3 ring. Yeah, exactly. There's hardly any difference. And the aggressor shield is just +4. Jesus fuck. Yeah, that's really bad. Oh, yeah. Actually, I have been... when I did my smoke-only run in DS3, what West Lowell returns, that one of my ideas was indeed to do a Soulstream only run. A Soulstream stream. Get it? Soulstream stream. Okay, so that's also a possibility. But what may be more interesting than that is the Double Dragon run. So if I go back to DS3 for live streams, then I might actually do that. Flutter down the gutter. Okay, so now we have the... Of course, I could also first go to Sief. What do you guys think? Should I now head towards the DLC or should I just continue with the Duke's Archives and just kill Sief first? What do you guys think? I hope you know that's one of the few things I relate to you, that Poopa thing or whatever. Yeah, there is no Dragon Ball cosplay really in Dark Souls 3. Yeah, DLC, of course, everyone wants the DLC. Oh no, Chicken Warriors, that's Sief. Okay, then we're going to head towards the DLC. I already lit the archive bonfire. Well, I'm not going to save the DLC. Hey, oh, that's a corpse. I was like, huh? Huh? And now that's very glitchy. Can you actually, yeah, you can actually move them, but oh, no, that was missed. Nah, not really. Or Sief without skip. Actually, can you even do the do skip when... when fat rolling? I actually don't think you can. I think you would have to do a jump attack, like this. That will be very hard to time. If you even can get it to work. Because I don't think you can do the Duke skip when fat rolling. Alright, let's at least head towards the DLC. I don't have... the problem, of course, as I said, is timing. Well, because I can only stream in these blocks of 4 hours at most. And I have to fit in the run in some way. So I guess just getting rid of the DLC bosses as quickly as possible kind of helps. I love how respectful this chat is compared to other chats I've been in. Well, maybe if you're in the chat of female streamers, because they're all talking in very specific ways. Or what kind of chats have you been in then, Baiku Nicholas? Because I would have to say that generally speaking, my audience is very respectful. Of course, they talk about feet too much, but yeah. Damn it, I shouldn't have mentioned that. Fuck. Not good, especially since Brutox is in the chat, and he is a little too fanatical when it comes to that. Did you know you can exit Sea's boss first encounter? Yes. Yes, you can actually walk out through the fork wall. That's the only fork wall you can do that. Which is kind of interesting. Of course, you can't actually go anywhere, but yeah, without the Dukeskip, and the Dukeskip is a developer oversight, it's not like you can actually go anywhere to begin with, so. Oh boy, yeah, I got it started again. I shouldn't have done that. Actually, when it comes to the feet of the Iron Golem, in this light you cannot really see it that well. But he has like rusty feet or something, or dirty feet. His feet are a bit more brownish, or like dark greenish or something. He must have come from NEMS38 stream. That name sounds familiar, actually. But I can't really picture who that is, but I think I've heard that name before. Getting cold feet. Yeah, dirty feet, Ishmael. Oh boy, the Sanctuary Guardian with his with his lightning attacks. That's gonna suck. Oh, yes, he's a world record holder speedrunner. Ah. What if Iron Golem is actually bronze? It's like when bronze rusts, is it like it turns green or something? Because that's possible. That would be kind of false advertising, that if the Iron Golem is actually bronze, but called the Iron Golem. Yeah, like the Maiden in Black with dirty feet. They actually made her feet dirty in the remake. Which I guess makes sense if she walks around the Nexus constantly with naked feet. Will you do a DS1 community run? I could, but of course the problem is that contrary to Bloodborne, where you have to be on PS4 or PS5, but a lot of my audience that play when they play DS1, they don't play on PS4 or PS5. So, and there is no there's no inter-platform multiplayer or whatever word you want to use for that. So anyone who is on PC cannot join my stream when I'm on PS4 or PS5. Crossplay, yes, exactly. Alright. I actually think that in this case, maybe instead of the stamina ring, I should equip the Thunder Stoneplate ring, because maybe that prevents me from just immediately dying from those lightning attacks. Of course, I don't know exactly how much damage will get reduced. Fuck, I have absolutely no idea how to fight any of the DLC bosses while fat rolling, because I've never done that. So, yeah, this is gonna suck. Because I know how to successfully avoid all of Sanctuary Guardian's attacks when you can fast roll, especially even with the flip ring. But I did SL1 Nuka plus 7, I used the flip ring, which is very effective against this boss. Like the 4-hit combo, if you run away from it, given how slow I am, I might not even be able to outrun it. You just need to kill him. Oh, that's a good tip, Smoku. So I just need to defeat him. You defeat him by killing him. You kill him until he dies. Ah, that's a great tip. I want to invade you, but you only have PC. Yeah, then it's not possible. Okay, well, let's first figure out how to avoid these attacks. Okay, well, at least that one. Oh, well, that one can be rolled through. Okay, now I missed. Oh, and now I'm oh fuck, I'm actually poisoned. Oh, he does stagger quickly. And I don't have any purple moss, of course, equipped. Oh, fuck. Well, just... we'll just imagine that... oh, fuck. Ah, no, 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 that doesn't work. That doesn't work, that doesn't work at all. Okay, this is not good. Well, just imagine that we have power within now. And that's why we're losing health. Well, at least my damage output is pretty good. Oh! Oh, you can actually avoid that. That's good. And I hit the tail. Oh, fuck. Can I run this? No. Oh, okay, I'm dead. Huh, well, at least my damage output is much higher than I expected, so that's good. Go kill him until he dies. Exactly, that's exactly what I'm planning to do. Can blocking help? Not sure. Maybe. Power outside. Yeah, he's very fast and I'm very slow. But I think we can figure this out. Oh, whoa, oh. Well, that's a lot of damage, but of course... I am wearing the stone plate ring, so that should have been more when if I did not wear it. Oh yeah, of course. I can still make use of the follow-up. Oh fuck, oh fuck, that's not good. Ah, no, and now... okay, I got lucky there. Well, the single bolt is not that that much of an issue. Oh, that one is an issue. Jesus. Can I hit the tail? Oh, no. No, I could not. Damn it, that one is also a problem. Ah, the forehead combo. Fuck, that's not good. Oh, whoa, I got lucky there. Oh, fuck, I was too early. Wow, I actually was too early. Jesus. Oh, yeah, damn it. Yeah, he's definitely a lot faster than me, but I think this should... I think this should be possible. Use rusted iron ring? The water doesn't slow you down. That's not required. He healed? What the fuck? The boss can't heal? What do you mean? Damn, I walk away for 5 minutes and I'm already in the DLC. That's a chimera, yes. Yes, it is. Oh, Kira, you're going. Well, thanks for being here, and hopefully I will see you next time. Uh-oh, that's of course that's the 4-1. Jesus. Okay, the forward combo, that's a problem. Oh, and this forward combo is also a problem. Yeah, damn it! He is so quickly, I can't even heal before he attacks me again. Is this a PC game? Well, it is a PC game, but I'm not on PC. I'm on PS5. And of course, it is the PS4 version. Oh, I can actually outrun it, even when I'm this slow. Okay, that's actually good to know. Of course, that doesn't work when you are far when you're close to him, but when you're far away. Fuck, I missed. But that's at least good to know. Okay. Quickly, get the tail. Ah, damn it. That was not a running attack. Ah, fuck. Okay, that was bad. Uh-oh, this is also bad. Jesus, fuck. Yeah. Okay, this is... Yeah, as I said, the DLC bosses are definitely... Kind of an issue. Maybe try to not fight in water. The entire arena is covered in water. I don't think the Rusted Iron Ring even does anything in this... I can equip it. Of course, now I probably will take massive damage from the lightning attacks, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. Okay. Okay, that works too. Oh, come on, I still missed. That was bad. Oh, fuck. Ah, oh, damn it. Uh-oh. Whoa. Ah, damn it, now I can't heal. I got lucky there. Okay, good. Oh! Okay. No, that's not the for it one. Come on. Yeah, for it? No, not for it. Oh yeah, now he does the for it when I'm not in the right position for it. Yeah? No, not for it. Yes. Ah, I whiffed. Oh, fuck. Damn it. Oh, no, come on. Oh, I shouldn't have healed, but yeah, I was like, I should heal. Damn it. That was actually a very good attempt, but no. I messed up at the end. I shouldn't have healed, but I was like, yeah, I should heal now near the end. To be real with your vids and streams really help me with stress from school and help me talk to people without actually talking to people. So I just want to say thanks for the great content. Oh, thank you so much, Ahmad. And I'm glad to help. Stress is not nice, especially for school. Yeah, you're still in school, so... Yeah, that was a big oof. That was a big oof, absolutely. I'm actually... Sid, I actually want to get hit by the wind attack. So that I can make use of the follow-up attack. So I'm intentionally getting hit by the wind attack. But we're getting closer already, so... And this is the easiest of the four DLC bosses. Oh, come on, that was not a hit. Oh, nice AI there. Okay, can't hit the till, but as long as I can get a hit in, that's okay. Okay, that's the 4-hit one, very good. Again, very good. Are you going to do something? Good. He's just standing there menacingly. Okay. Ah, come on! How can I whiff her? Okay, well, another attempt. Again? How the hell do I not hit it? Oh, fuck. Ah, no. Not the 4-hit one. Jesus, that's not good. Uh-oh. Well. Yeah, fuck. Couldn't get out of that. He's a JoJo fan, it's confirmed, what? Did I make some unintentional reference or something? Fat rolling is extremely based. Do range attacks, nah. It's too slow anyway. And he has better range attacks than I have. So when I'm far away, I can outrun it, as you can see, but... If he does it close by, then I don't have that same luxury. That also clipped me. F again. Oh fuck! Ah! Well, I got real lucky there. But given how fast he is, you really have to choose the right time to heal. And I'm not really doing that so far, so I should use attack opportunities to heal instead. Oh fuck, I was too early. Not good. Damn it. Yeah, now I'm not wearing the stone plate ring, so now it's a one-shot. Oh, well, two-shot technically, because it just... because of the water. Level 80p, exactly. Hi there, glad to watch you live. Well, thank you to the stream... Welcome to the stream, and thanks for watching, Jack Neal. I remember cosplaying Onion Man's Secret for a party. It did not come out well. That is pretty cool, by the way. Federal barehanded run next. No. Surprising, right? No, Iron Golem. The Iron Golem set has very low lightning resistance, and of course, on Nuka plus 6, he does shit ton of damage. Oh, damage the 4-1. Whoa, I got lucky. Holy crap, I got lucky again. Whoa, why the hell did I lock on? Okay, that was really dumb. Oh, fuck, and now he does twice in a row. And I'm now stuck in the corner, and I'm dead. Alright, I'm not dead, but... Which is surprising, by the way. Now I'm probably dead. Damn it, Now I'm stuck in a loop. Yeah. Yeah, this is the sound dude from Mike Litteris. Yeah. Oh, that was so bad in the previous stream that I did not get that one until I until eventually I did, but then it was too late. Yo, why don't you just like beat him in the one hit or one try? I guess, yeah. Exactly. You just gotta believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Okay, let's simply not go for the tail when he does that, because for some reason I keep missing the tail. So it's better to simply get damage in. Uh-oh, now it's probably now it's the 4-1. Oh, I can still avoid it? Wow. They did not expect that, but I'll take it. Can you stop spamming? What the fuck, dude? You think that's enough lightning? How much lightning do you want? Yes. Yeah, that's why I want to cut his tail, but yeah. It's not going to happen. God damn it, stop using these lightning attacks! Although I am very happy that I can still avoid them. Okay, fuck. Whoa. I don't know how I avoid that, but that was not. Oh, whoa. Nice stagger there. Oh fuck! Ah, that was the... Damn it! That was the big one. I thought it was the 4-1 and it was not. Yeah. Yeah, he's definitely an R-Worm spammer. Definitely. The power of friendship. You have to believe yourself and in your friends and you can achieve anything. Yeah, at least I do good damage. That's correct, Josh. My damage output is higher than I actually expected it to be. So that's good. Is Stormrule only a possible run on Nugent Plus? It's possible. You need a lot of repair powders, which you usually don't need in Dark Souls 3, because I assume you're referring to Dark Souls 3. Or are you referring to Demon Souls? Can be a little hard to tell which of these two lightning attacks he does, because the big one you cannot outrun after all. Huh? What the hell was that animation? Oh fuck, did you see? That's exactly what I meant, but I got real lucky. That was pure luck, but I'll take it. Fuck. Oh, crap. Okay, enough to heal. Fuck! Yeah, and I'm dead. Oh, I got luck. Wow. Say what you want, I get some really good luck in this attempt. Oh, fuck. I shouldn't push my luck. God damn it. Oh, fuck. Well, I got so lucky then it was bound to happen, of course. You have to use a lot of repair powder. Yeah, and if you in DS3, if you use only the Storm Brutal, then you have to use a lot of repair powder because that's basically the only weapon in the game that even can break, yeah, so to say. Yeah, this was in fact not the one. You're absolutely correct. Yeah, maybe you should actually re-equip the lightning ring, but yeah. Or I could just power within, by the way, but then again, if I get hit when my life is draining, then that's maybe not a good idea. Oh fuck, it's the 4-1. Uh-oh. Whoa! Okay. Again, the 4-1, but I wasn't ready. Oh, okay. Again, lucky. And now it's the big one! Oh, and now I'm on the ground? Oh, I'm already dead. I didn't even notice. Jesus. This is some fuck right here. Bro asked the guardian what size shoe he has. It's for a friend. What the fuck, dude? You're a weird guy, Brutox. You know that? Dark Hand. How do you get the Dark Hand on SL1? Don't you get the Dark Hand from Yuria? No, not Yuria. Yeah, Yuria. So you can't get the Dark Hand on SL1. This reminds me of that one Doom Classic level where Chad was going next attempt for like 2 hours. You mean House of Pain? Oh, and of course nobody was willing to tell me there that I was constantly going in the wrong direction. Because that was basically the problem in that level. I wasn't even taking the correct route. Oh fuck, ah. Oh, I got lucky again. Whoa, 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 that's a rare attack. He doesn't do that a lot. Oh, and now he does it twice in a row, wow. He does it 3 times in a row, what the hell? He hardly ever does that attack and now he does it 3 times in a row. Damn it, I still get hit. Ah, again. Damn it, I should have healed there, but. Oh! Damn it, now I was again not ready. Now I could at least hit the tail, but of course I'm not going to be able to cut it. Ah, fuck! No, I'm not ready! Oh, just in time. Oh, and now the big one. Oh no! He does it again! Oh, this guy is such a troll. Oh, fuck. Oh, and now the big... Jesus, come on! This guy is trolling me so fucking hard! What a fucking troll. Yeah. Oh, hey, I got a super chat. From Gabriel Hawk. This is to help you with all the monster hunting endeavors. Go, press go. Thank you so much, Gabriel. £5 donation. Very generous. Hopefully I can now, as a thank you, beat him next try. But of course, I can't promise that, unfortunately. Sanctuary Guardian is trolling me really hard. Oh, that's the big one again. It was the big one again. It's so hard to tell which one he's going to do. It's so hard to tell the difference between the four bolts and the single big bolt. I'm still waiting for the Doom Eternal Ultra Nightmare Guide. Yeah, you can wait a long time, because that's not going to happen. What's your favorite game? I would say Bloodborne. Oh, ah! Damn it! I'm against the wall here. Not fast enough! Can I... Oh, come on! That was not a whiff! Bullshit! That looked like a hit to me, but yeah, apparently not. Oh, now she's going to spam again. Of course, of course, of course. Oh, he does that attack again. Ooh. Can you stop? Oh, fuck, and he does the big one again. Jesus, I thought... I just cannot recognize when he does the big one or the small ones. Okay, that was basically just a guess. Ah, come on, why do I keep whiffing on the still? I don't get that. Okay, that's good at least. The wind attack he can spam as much as he wants. But the lightning attacks, no. Damn it, not fast enough. Okay, wind attack, that's always good. Oh, come on! That was bullshit! How the hell did I miss that? Come on! Of course. No, fuck, I'm dead. Oh. Okay, I'm lucky. Because this should be it. Okay, I got really lucky there at the end. Because if he did the normal charge attack, then I would have been dead. So. Yeah, it was kind of luck that I won, but I won, so I take it. Hey, Shmoku Fuji Warrior, super chat. Feat of Lucky Shmoku gives character plus 5 chance to dodge enemy attack. Thank you so much for 100... Oh yeah, you're Russian? Are you Russian? Ruble. I think those are 100 rubles. Thank you so much for the super chat, Shmoku. I appreciate that. Alright, well there he goes. Yeah, it kind of sucks that I literally won because I got real lucky, but I'll take it. I'll take it. Hey, a W is a W, that's exactly correct. Huh, so, that was Sanctuary Guardian. And that was the easiest of the DLC boss. Wait, I'm going the wrong direction. I think. Hey, another one. Jurgen, a 5-pound donation. I just got here, so this must be first try, right? Yeah, I'll just say so. It was the first try that counts. Let's just say that. This one... Wait, now I'm going the wrong direction. I'm such an idiot. 100% he did not need to press continue. Yeah, that's true. You wouldn't have gotten this far with only luck. No, that's not what I meant. I meant that at the end, when I went for the heal, if he did a normal charge attack, I would have died. But given that he did the wind attack, I got lucky and I was able to get the final hit in. So that's what I meant. Oh, and Bushy Potato with a super chat. Everyone is very super chatty at the moment. So with $2, $1.99 super chat, should have named the character Zenitsu. Works every time. Yeah, this one is not called Zenitsu. It's called Blarf. I don't know why, but I called it Blarf. So it's kind of meaningless, but yeah. But thank you so much. God character limits. Wait, you have character... I don't know exactly how many character limits... what the character limit is in this specific game. So this character's name is Blarf. So, I'm actually going to take a piss, and then we're going towards Artorias, I think. Oh boy, Artorias is going to be way harder than the Sanctuary Guardian, so I would be surprised if I can even beat him in the remainder of the stream, but then get blarfed on. Yeah, the Manus fight will also be very hard. Absolutely. So, okay, let's sit at the bonfire, and I'm going to take a piss, and I'll be back in a minute or two.
Alright, I'm back. So, oh boy, now we're going to head towards Artorias. That's going to be nice. Sanctuary Guardian already gave me that much trouble, and Artorias is going to be way harder. In fact, I'm actually thinking about what attacks can I even
punish when fat rolling. Jesus fuck. Okay, this is going to... Okay, prediction. The rest of the stream is going to be attempts against Artorias, and the successful attempt will probably only be in the next stream. But yeah, first we'll wait and see how I'm even just going to avoid any attacks. Of course, first I need to open up the shortcut, and it's also not really a good shortcut, but yeah, you know how it is. By the way, I can actually equip the fork ring, that helps a bit. How do you get Iron Golem armor? What's that NPC again? The NPC with the glasses on his armor. That one that's under the bridge where the Ring of Sacrifice is, you know, at the near Farling Shrine. After you beat the Iron Golem, then he sells the armor set. So that's how you get it. Oh yeah, okay. Now I'm going the right direction. Oh shit, I haven't finished the DLC, but I have a good stream. Oh, okay, you don't want spoilers. Domal, yeah. Hi, killer mate. Yeah, if you already could do damage to him, that would be nice, but yeah, it's not possible. Shame. I swear you just sound like my friend Skeletor. Meh. Hey. I can't really do a Skeletor voice. I don't sound like Skeletor. Yeah. Just like a woman. That's the best I could do. That's a fine trade there, that is. Okay. Yeah, something like that, Greedy Orange. Greedy Orange? That's an interesting one. You should play Hollow Knight. Yeah, a lot of people have said that. Well, there are a whole bunch of things that I want to do before Elden Ring's come out, and... damn it, it's been a long time since I've even been here. Okay, yeah, this is the right one. Okay. So many stuff to do and so little time. Okay, now first, of course, open up the actual shortcut. Well, one game I want to try pretty soon is, because now I have a PS5, I want to try Returnal. So I, of course, whenever I do non-Souls-related content, it's always very questionable how well my audience reacts to that. But Returnal was definitely a game that I am very much interested in. Unfortunately, of course, because the PS5 is still so rare, that makes the potential audience even rarer, because other people that are interested in the game as well probably haven't even played it yet, so... Yeah, your PS5 is bricked, Jesus fuck, you're one of the few people who has a PS5 and then you have a bricked one. That sucks. Liliana, it's in the title, it's Max NG, so NG6, NG plus 6. Any content from you is great, don't worry. Well, I appreciate that, Gabriel. Okay, fuck. Artorias is going to be a disaster. Oh, by the way, I still have the fork ring equipped. That's not good. I need the stamina ring, of course. Okay, how is this going to work? Well, that works at least. That works. Oh fuck, that didn't work. I think this is going to be more of a spacing fight than a rolling fight. Oh fuck, okay, that was not correct spacing. Uh-oh. Oh fuck. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, this is going to be tough. This is going to be tough. I see. I thought that meant all cycles up to New Game Plus 6 in a row. No, 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 no. Jesus fuck, dude. How long do you want this series to be? What is your opinion on Jorge from Elden Ring? What the hell? I don't even know what you're referring to. Knight, yeah, the sense of Knight Artorias, yeah, very good. Stats, level 200. But of course, a New Game Plus 6, your stats don't really mean that much anymore. Because you take enormous damage. Of course, the moment I allow Artorias to buff, then he will basically one-shot me. So I definitely need to prevent him from doing that. Okay, now let's equip the stamina ring. Okay, it's all the way in the other end. How is that so? The helmet guy from the Elden Ring promotional art was named Jorge? Or however you pronounce that. I didn't know that. But yeah, this is definitely going to be a very difficult fight, this. I can at least dodge through it, but can I get away then? Spacing is more effective, of course, but it's also... Ah, whoa, holy crap! Okay, now I'm dead already, Jesus! Yeah, the problem with spacing is, of course, that I run also slower than normal, so that's also not going to be that great. I hate that the run back is so terrible on... Notorious. Well, at least if I switch back between Ring of Fork and the Stamina Ring, then it makes the run back a little bit better. Oh, I was looking at the stream chat and I almost walked on the wrong side of the bridge. You need to get 35 hits. Okay. Well, running attacks do a little more damage, but it will be around that number then. Yeah, if it helps things about loot and Zalan. Yeah, okay, but that's of course the worst run back in basically any game. Actually, no. The worst run back in any game is the final bosses of the first Ninja Gaiden. That's the worst run back in any game. In case you don't know what I'm talking about, in the first, in the very first Ninja Gaiden game, if you die against the three final bosses, then it sets you back three stages. And I think the story behind that, that was the result of a developer oversight that they intentionally did not fix or something like that. So that's, yeah, that's definitely the worst run back in any game ever. Oh, okay, I'm too slow to counterattack after that one. Damn it. Ooh. Oh, fuck. Oh, he actually landed on top of me. Jesus, fuck. I didn't even get a single hit in.
Well, that set the tone for the rest of the stream. Oh, the worst run back is the Nier prologue. Yeah, Nier Automata. That's a good point. That is a good point. I'm vaguely aware of a boss in some game that only gives you one attempt per playthrough, but which game does this elude me? Only one attempt per playthrough? Technically, the Vanguard in Demon's Souls, of course you encounter him later on, but the tutorial version, you only get one per playthrough. In fact, even on New Game Plus and beyond, you will never go back to the tutorial, so... I guess that counts, but I don't think that's the one you were referring to. Torius is playing on easy difficulty and one hand. Oh, fuck, ah. That's not good. Yes, exactly. The Nier Armada prologue is around 40 minutes, hard reset on death. That's correct. Whether that is worse than Ninja Gaiden, that's debatable, but it's around the same level of frustration, I would say. This is going to be a pain, we all know it, yeah? That should already be very, very clear. Oh fuck, I actually missed my attack. Oh fuck. Jesus, dude. Okay, that doesn't work. Oh fuck! Damn it, I don't even know when I should heal. Artorias doesn't really allow you that much time to heal, after all. Ugh, shit, that doesn't work. I can see from the corner of my eye that I have another super chat, but of course I cannot look at the stream chat at the moment. But in advance, thank you for the super chat. I'll read it after I wanted to say after I die, but that's not the right attitude. But it is accurate. Ah, fuck. Uh-oh, I'm dead. Give me time to heal. Okay, the black sludge doesn't do a lot of damage, so that's fine. Oh fuck, he actually hit me. Jesus. Uh-oh. He's going to buff. Yeah, okay, now I'm dead. I cannot get him out of that, so... Now I'm fucked. Because now he does a shit ton more damage than he already did. That is exactly what I needed to prevent, but I wasn't able to prevent it. Woo! Damn it, I didn't know if he was going to follow up, so that's a good thing I didn't attack at least, I guess. But when can I... There's so few opportunities... Oh! Can I heal after this? No. No, I could not. That is not a moment to heal. Jesus. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Okay, let's read the super chat. Hey, Gabriel Hawk. Okay, so this is the bribe for Artorias. Use it wisely. Thank you so much for the £5 super chat. But I don't think that Artorias takes bribes, unfortunately. Would be nice, but that's not going to work. I got Nier Automata and closed the game like an hour. I'm not bowing about no autosave. Well, after the prologue, saving is no longer really an issue. Well, there's some areas maybe, but it's really only the prologue. Once you get past the prologue, things are definitely less extreme. Well, I did already a bit better, but the problem is I simply don't know exactly when I can get safe attack opportunities in when fat rolling. So you gotta head out, Julenkinjus. I don't know how to pronounce your name, but thanks for being here, and hopefully I will see you next time, which will be next Thursday, by the way. Compliment Artorias on his large sword. Well, it is a pretty nice sword. That's definitely the case. If you get it yourself, you can actually do the flip attacks that he can do as well. You learn when you can heal in time. Oh, by the way, I should equip the fork ring again. Of course, I still got clipped actually by an attack on the previous run back. Oh, someone ran off a cliff, apparently. What if a Taurus has a shield? Yeah, that's with a lot of bosses, you're like, you don't fight them in their prime, and then you wonder, what would it be like to fight them in their prime? I mean, Gwyn is also not in his prime, so... Do the range attack for the axe? Yeah, but when? When is that a safe attack? You can heal after you died, yeah. Have you ever played Devil May Cry 5? No, I have not. So the wind attack is, it's a very slow attack. So I see your attack. You see how long it takes before you can roll? Not quite sure when that will really come in handy. Oh, oops, ooh, that's the wrong wing. Gwyn is not in his prime. No, he's not. He is not. He's even referred to as the fading Lord Gwyn by Kaath. Okay, nice start. Oh! Okay, through the sludge I can attack, even if it would hit me. Oh! That's not... Oh, fuck, that... Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh... Okay, that's not safe. Yeah, that is my best opportunity, basically, if I can outspace that attack. If I can. I can also roll through it, but then I... need to get lucky whether he will... How he's going to recover from that. Oh, fuck. Ooh, that was not smart. Oh, fuck. That was really not smart. Okay, got lucky there. Oh, fuck. Oh, I have to be really careful. God damn it. Jesus. Uh-oh. Oh, you can actually poise through that. Okay, that was nice at least. Okay.
Oh, fuck. Oh, crap. Again, that's something I need to watch out for. Oh, fuck. Well, good thing that it's a good thing that you can poise through that, but again, finding healing opportunities is definitely an issue. Oh. Oh, whoa, wow, damn, I jumped. What the fuck? That's not what I wanted to do. Yeah, that's not good. Okay, I'm dead. Almost dead. Yeah. Oh, fuck. This is not good. Damn it, I cannot outrun him. No, it's not going to work. Oh. I want to use the ability, but it's not. Yeah. Crap. Now it's. Whoa, I got lucky there. Oh, but now I'm fucked. Yeah, Artorias is like, you want to heal? No, we don't do that here. Yeah, you see, every time I try to heal, I just get hit again. Yeah. Artorias doesn't like that I like it when I try to heal, and he's like, no, not going to happen. Oh, fuck. Okay, now I'm dead. Shit. Yeah, this is a rough fight. Yeah, basically just every time I try to heal, then I just get hit immediately after that. Mm. Yeah, just don't get hit and you don't need to heal. It's a win-win. Yeah, good point. Good point. I place my bets that this is impossible. No, it's not impossible. It's just hard to do. But I did better already. That's true. So it can be done. It's just rough. I just keep getting stuck in these healing loops. How long do you stream tonight? Probably for another half hour or so. May have to block with your axe during some of his fast attacks when you can out. Yeah. Could possibly help. Have you tried talking to Artorias? Maybe just need someone to listen. Yeah, just sit him down on those one of those psychiatrist couches. Would kind of work. Oh, you should send the elevator back up. Yes. Yes, I should. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. I do wish that they made a better run back for Artorias, but yeah. Unfortunately. Yeah, but Francisco, but that is a little bit different because when you do no rolling, then you're not moving this slowly, yeah? So it's sort of similar, but it's not the same as no roll threats, because then you have to move fast. Because if I do like this, you see how much faster I am. So then you can completely rely on spacing, which is incredibly difficult already. But when I'm wearing the full armor, it's not just my rolling that is different. Look at the difference in speed. I'm so much slower now. So you cannot just rely on no roll strats. At least you have to use different no roll strats then. And I'm not exactly very familiar with no roll strats for a Taurus to begin with. So oh fuck, he still hit me. And I didn't hit him. What kind of sense did that make? Of course. Now I'm stuck in those healing loops again. Yeah, I don't know what to do about those healing loops. Yeah, other than not heal, but oh, that still hit me. Oh, huh? That broke my poise? So, his somersaults don't break my poise, and that black sludge did? What the fuck? That was kind of bullshit. Oh fuck. Jesus. Okay, now I have to heal, but I'm still in a healing loop. How do I get out of those healing loops? Fuck. Well, that might work. Oh no, no, it doesn't. Whoa, how the hell did they even avoid that second hit? If I outspaced that one, I could have saved the heal, but it worked out at least. Yeah, that wasn't really a good opportunity. Okay. Ah, for who? Oh, 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 oh. Again, the sludge breaks my poise for some reason. Oh, fuck. Ooh. Okay, healing loop. Oh, no. I got lucky there. Ooh, fuck. Didn't see it in time. Okay, that was a guess, and that was a good guess. Oh, fuck. Come on. Damn it, I missed. Ooh, fuck. Damn, it was too slow. Oh, fuck! That actually hit me. What the hell? It was a bit of a risk, but... Okay, that wasn't safe anyway. Fuck me, oh fuck, that was not good. Ooh. Damn it, how do I keep missing? Also sucks that I completely forgot to re-equip the quarantine ring, but... Oh, goddammit! Oh fuck! Ah, he actually hit me! I wanted to use that as a healing opportunity. Well, I lucked out, but... Oeh. Oh, he still clipped me. Jesus. Fuck. Ooh. Quick. Okay. Yeah, the lack of quarantine ring is definitely noticeable, and the fork ring is of course not helping me at all. Nor would you expect it to. Huh? Oh. Yeah, that wasn't safe anyway. Ooh. Damn it, I whiffed again. Jesus. Ooh. Fuck. Come on, give me some actual attacks that I can punish. Okay, that works. Woo. Ah, damn it, I missed. Ah! Fuck! Oh, fuck. Ooh, that was bad. Okay, good. Good. Oh, I'm not in time! Damn it. Ooh! Oh, he actually hit me! What the fuck? Fuck, now I need to find an opportunity to heal. Ah! No! This is bad. Yeah, that was a guess. Fuck! Uh-oh. This sucks! Oh. No! Come on, give me some better RNG. Okay. Oh, fuck! Oh, I got greedy. Got him. Yes, got him. Whew! Damn it! Jesus, that's completely different than how you usually fight him. Jesus, motherfucking. Motherfucking fuck up the motherfucker. Huh. Well, that was... And I was so stupid to completely forget to equip the clonity ring before entering the boss fight. So I was constantly in my invisible mode, which of course is not helpful. Yeah. Okay, that was less attempts than I was expecting, but I'm very happy that I managed to make through it, even without the Glorantee Ring. Let's get my zero souls back. Huh. And I only had one Estus left. Yeah, I don't know if there were more opportunities to hit him while fat rolling, but this was what I was able to figure out, so... Holy shit, give this man a pussy. I appreciate the sentiment, Tarek. Maybe Forkring helped you because your character didn't block the view. I suppose. Yeah, that was an intense fight. That was definitely an intense fight. I agree with that. Yeah. Of course, we still have Manus left, and we still have Calamite left. Calamite is definitely going to be even harder than Artorias, I think. It's Calamite's terrible hitboxes. Manus... not sure. Might be doable, but of course... The lack of... that you have less iframes when fat rolling, yeah... Yeah, my hands are sweaty. Mom spaghetti. And Manus has a shit ton of health, so it's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. Actually, the Ring of Fog might actually be helpful when going through Ulasil. Oh, pfft. You're gonna use the pendant again, Manus? Yes, definitely. Fortunately, I already have it, so that's a good thing. This might actually be helpful. Oh, and it's probably because of the Ring of Fog, but I don't think they can actually see me. Oh. Smackdown! the Ring of Pork. Would you say Mans is the hardest DLC boss? I think Calamite is the hardest DLC boss. But a lot of that has to do with his with the hitboxes, which are not the greatest. But I think we all know that. Oh, I think my weapon is going to be at risk Let's use some repair powder. By the way, I was thinking when using the silver pendant with Manus, I only always use it against his forward magic attack. But, well, the circle one, I think I would still be fast enough to run towards him, I hope. But the dark rain is running backwards going to be fast enough. Otherwise, I have to use the pendant on that attack. And the problem with that attack is that you can get actually a projectile stuck on top of you. And then the moment the pendant effect wears off, it falls on your head. So that's going to be an issue, possibly. Yeah. For me, the hardest DLC boss is Calamite Steel. there is, if he does the swoop attack, then you get an opportunity to cut it, at least. But actually, it's helpful if you don't cut it, because then he can keep doing that swoop attack, and that means you get more attack opportunities. Oh! Get bow and arrows and kill Manus from a distance. No. No, I'm not going to do that. And he's looking like, huh? What has happened? Of course. Oh, fuck. Ah! Okay, that was fast enough. Very good. Bandit is bad against rain in general. Yes, exactly. I like the fact that you stay hydrated. I hear it all the time. Yes, exactly. It's my bottle of water I have here. That's good, but yeah, of course, because I'm constantly talking, like, oh. And in general, it's good to stay hydrated. Unfortunately, in my case, I constantly have to take a piss, so that's that kind of sucks. The fog ring is pretty helpful in this area, by the way, so... Oh, that's not helpful. Yeah, we'll just skip the mimic. Fortunately, I cannot knock him off. The other guy doesn't see me, that's good. I fucked the wall. Oh, by the way, did I even I got the super chat that I... Oh, I did read it, by the way, because that was when I died. Okay, that's used to bribe for a tourist, that was right. Kind of forgot when I exactly got that one. Totally not a medic, promise. Good examples. Yeah. It wasn't a critique, I love it because it's important, so stay like that. Yeah, you're completely correct. You have to drink enough water every day. Of course, you shouldn't take a piss as many times as I do, but that's another issue. By the way, I was thinking, because originally my idea for this live stream was the... You know, I did a poll after all. Was to do the toxic and poison run, but of course I already did it in Demon Souls. But these sorcerers, they have a staff that actually inflicts a poison attack, but the drop is so rare that you can literally farm for hours and you still won't get it. So I don't know why that catalyst is so rare, because it's not even a good catalyst to begin with, but. Yeah, it's unnecessarily rare. Of course, at some point I could still do that run, but as I said, I did basically the same type of run in Demon's Souls as well. So, and I do think that this run is harder than that one, because at least I'm maneuverable in that build. Al dat pissen kan ook gewoon een soa zijn. Ja, nee, dan zou het branden als ik aan het pissen ben. En dat is gelukkig niet het geval. I love when you can roll and flip the ragdoll enemy of an edge. Yeah, I agree. That's another reason why Dark Souls 2 is inferior, because it doesn't have ragdoll mechanics. He's laughing at me! What a dick! You're not supposed to laugh at me here. I laugh behind your back. Okay, this mimic I do have to kill. Because I want the key, of course. Alright. I just understood Brownus Wasser? What? Oh, Wiki says that Catalyst is a 0.5% chance to drop. Jesus fuck, that's dumb. I replace water with Red Bull. I think I have a problem. Yes, then you definitely have a problem. Dark Souls 3 allows you to be the Vape Master. You can have 4 or 5 different cartridges with so many different effects. Well, I am already the Vape Master because I did smoke only run. What do you think about people who want an easy mode for Souls games? Personally, I do not think they should have one because they already have features to make the game... Souls games have easy modes, except for Sekiro. So I think that's a really stupid thing to say when people say that Dark Souls needs an easy mode. It has an easy mode. It has an easy mode. It's not a menu-based easy mode. Souls games have mechanics-based difficulty settings. So it doesn't have a menu, but it has mechanics that allows you to change up the difficulty from easier to higher. So when people say that Dark Souls needs an easy mode, then they overlook the fact that it already has one. Moreover, on top of that, even if you had a menu-based easy mode, what would that look like? So you could, for example, have an easy mode where you have where you take 10% less damage. Would that be enough? Probably not, right? So what would an easy mode look like? Would enemies have less attacks? Is it just merely a slider for the amount of damage you take? What would be really required as an for an easy mode that gaming journalists would be satisfied with? Because I would assume that even if they made an easy mode, it would still be too hard for... I went the wrong way. It would still be too hard for gaming journalists anyway, so yeah. But in general, I'm completely fine with games having easy modes, but I am against the idea that every game requires an easy mode. Some games are just not designed for that. So if you like games easy, then this is not the game for you to begin with. So why would it need an easy mode? If it's not your type of game. That's like saying, I'm not a big fan of racing games. So a racing game should have a mode where it's not all about racing. It's silly. 1,000 points would be easy mode. Yeah, I guess so. Gaming jewelers can't even get through Cuphead's tutorial. Yes, exactly. But who the hell takes gaming journalists serious to begin with? Oh, how do I do this? Because now I have two enemies around the corner, and of course those sorcerers. Well, I do have the fork ring equipped, but okay. Damn it, two at once. That's a bit of an issue. Oh, I got lucky there. Okay, now I need to lure that one over. Oh, that's not... It's a little hard to aim when you're not locked on. But I can't lock on. But oh, now I can lock on. Wrong. What is your favorite weapon in DS1? Ooh, that's a good question. What is my favorite weapon in this game? Well, I'm so used to playing Hassel 1 that my first reaction would be
the giant blacksmith hammer, but I'm... Ooh. That's a good question. I'm actually not completely sure. I cleaned up my item box, so... I can't really take a look. What is my favorite weapon in this game? I don't really have just a ready answer for that. I do have to say when I went through my... I can't really remember my first playthrough, but initially I really liked spear weapons. Specifically the winged spear and the silver knight spear. But I kind of grew out of that, so to say. I used to want to be a games journalist, and then I learned to play how to play games. Yeah, then you're not suitable to be a games journalist, apparently. Uchi katana's not. Yeah, I don't like katanas in Souls games. They feel out of place. Yeah, of course, Black Knight Halberd, but yeah, that's the most overpowered weapon in the game. Yeah, the Baldur's side sword, actually, for when it comes to regular swords, that's definitely a very good one. Because most of the swords in this game are a bit meh. Okay, the slow but steady approach in this this part of the game definitely is more effective. Oh fuck, there's that one really weird looking enemy that's in the back here. How am I going to fight that one? Because I don't even know what the moveset of that enemy is. Like, what do you do when you... what do you level when you play for fun and stuff? When is the last time... that would be from before I started my channel, so I don't even really remember. So, I don't know, that's from before my before I had my channel. When the elevator comes up, there's actually an enemy on top of it, so... I guess I could... Ooh, he has a shit ton of health. Well, maybe if I... Oh! That's... He's designed to go back that quickly? I can guess I can use wind attacks. Oh, ah, fuck! Whoa, that was stupid. Whoa, he does a lot of damage. Damn it, I have no idea what this moveset is. There's only one of these enemies in the game to begin with. Whoa, he has more range than you would think. Whoa, he still hit me, Jesus! Damn it! Okay, he staggered twice for some reason, that was kinda weird. Woo! He narrowly avoided that. Okay, got him. I actually don't know if this guy respawns, actually. Well, hopefully I don't have to get through this section again to begin with. Oh wait, there's only the destroyer of enemy randomizer runs. Yeah, I can imagine that. There's only one more enemy here, and that's coming up with the elevator. Maybe I can actually knock him off. Ah, that works. What capture card do you use? Elgato HD60? I think that's it. Okay, that was Crestfallen Knight. Well, he drops pieces of the... what's it again? The chainmail armor. that was hell. What the fuck? Or is that the German Geil? Because the Dutch word Geil means horny.
No, Master Bow, I have never played Hollow Knight.
It's a bit too late to try Manus, because I'm almost going to stop streaming. What I could do is, of course, go back to... you know, to trigger Calamite, so that I can get Hawkeye Goff to shoot him down. That's maybe a better idea.
Horny Knight Gal.
Of course. Yeah, I know what kind of audience I have, after all. He was probably just a random guy who mutated into a blob man and various pieces of debris melted into his body. Oh, hey, by the way, we have Kira in here. So that was for the poison and toxic run. This was going to be my my setup. Let's take a look if I even have everything still. So I maybe at some point I could still do that, but this is what was my original idea. I think I... Oh, and the Pyro Flame for... Or did I have something else? For Toxic Mist or whatever. So the bow would be for poison arrows, then we have the Dark Silver Tracer that actually has a toxic buildup when you do stab attacks. The Guardian Tail, which actually sucks as a weapon, but it has poison buildup as well. And it's a whip, so that's a quite unique type of weapon. And then the Pyro Flame was for like poison mist, toxic mist, or that kind of stuff. So that was my original idea, at least. Alright. Damn it, even when after cleaning up my inventory, I still have way too much stuff. Okay, first trigger Calamite. After all that stuff, I'm going to release some toxic gas myself in a couple of hours. Well, thank you for sharing that, Greedy Orange. I really appreciate that. Hey, we have a bot again. Are the mods still in the moderator still in the stream? It might actually be that the moderators are gone. Because then I will have to block it myself. Okay, it's already done. Okay, Ishmael, yeah. Ishmael is still here. What the hell is the point of all those porn bots? It's really weird. And that they even can get in a chat, that's really weird. Press voices, airport. Oh, fuck, that's right. The dogs here. That's going to be... that's going to suck when fighting Calamite over and over again, because I'm way too slow to avoid them. They're already a nightmare. Ah, and I keep whiffing for some reason. And of course, as we also really got annoyed by in the previous stream, dogs actually have iframes when they dodge, when they jump away. As you can see. Yeah, that's going to be nice when doing all the Calamite attempts, constantly having these dogs in the way. You got it, my mouse fell asleep, what the fuck? Oh, they smelled horny night hell. Yeah, you're completely correct. And there goes Calamite. They either exist to bait people into clicking on var- Oh yeah, it's something like that, yes. Yeah, it's lame as shit. It's not just you, by the way, I've seen them everywhere. Oh, I assume. Yeah, probably goes to some sort of a scam website or something with viruses or whatever it is. It's shit, at least. And something to completely, to immediately ban. Wait, you will not ask Giant to arrow him, of course, but I first have to trigger him. Oh, I actually wanted to get the Titanite Slap, but I probably won't get the opportunity, or will I? I will. Alright.
So now we can get... that's what you first need. You first need to trigger Calamite once, and then Hawkeye Goff can shoot him down. Otherwise, he will not do that. Yeah, dorks are the bane of the world in Dark Souls. I completely agree with you there. Okay, so now we can visit Goff. Which is weird, by the way. Smo and Goff, you basically write in the same way, only with SM or G. But Smo is pronounced Smo, apparently. And Goff is not Go, but Goff. I was actually wondering, by the way. The Japanese name for Smo is Sumo. So is that like based on the sumo wrestler? Because Smo is a fat ass? Yeah. Smo is based on the word sumo. Exactly, that's what I was thinking. You have to die, you can use Homer Bone. You can use Homer Bone. Of course, dying there didn't matter in any way, but... Sumo Smo. Smo's pose is vaguely similar to sumo wrestler's pose. Oh, okay. Kind of makes sense. Of course, sumo wrestlers don't have giant hammers. Especially not the lightning variety. Smo can be very slim under armor. Yeah, based on concept art, Smo is actually not fat. His armor is fat, but not Smo himself. Google. Okay, let's talk to... Visitor. Must be the one who freed our toy. Exactly, that's me. Yeah, I'm happy to kill him. Well, we do take credit for... Well, actually, it's the other way around. He takes credit for what we did, of course. It's based on legend, and it's not Taurus's fault, but... Oh, oops. Okay, first... okay. And then now he should be able to shoot down Calamite. Yeah. All right. I thought as much. It's called Calamite. Ferocious dragon. A wise choice. Oh, fuck. Oh, oops. That's not what I wanted. That was not what I wanted to do. Okay. All the way around. Yep. Hey, but now he doesn't do it anymore. Do I have to go back to the bonfire now, since I picked a... Ah, crap. I think I have to go back to the bonfire now. Oh, but maybe just quitting the game is already enough. Yeah, I was looking at the stream chat again, so I clicked the wrong... answer. Calamite. Yeah, that's not really true. Hey, and if you're Dutch, why do you have lul in your name? I mean, that's have an hoop gelul. Yeah, safeguard will already work, I think. Yes, okay, yeah, that works. Ah, that's a great cutscene. I absolutely agree. Yeah, he should actually have 360 before no-scoping Calamite. Yeah, and he's blind. Yes, exactly. Yeah, that you actually have to answer no to the parameter. That's kind of weird, yeah. It is what it is. Okay. Well, it's too late to fight another boss, I think. But then next stream we can. I'm actually going to start with Manus. I usually do Manus before Calamite, and I think Manus is going to be a little more doable than Calamite, probably. Unfortunately, we still have quite a way after the DLC, so it'll still take two streams, but I think we can fill that. Alright. Well, that was a good stream at least. I mean, we beat the Four Kings, we beat the Sanctuary Guardian, and we beat Artorias. So, those are definitely some of the hardest bosses out of the way. And Artorias took less time than I expected that it would. In fact, it took less time than the Four Kings, which is kind of surprising. Anyway, so the next stream is going to be Thursday, and then the stream after that, that's inevitably going to be the case, will be Sunday. So it's the same as this week, only next week. So, thank you all for being here, and hopefully I will see you all back on Thursday. So, 8 p.m. CEST. Thanks all for being here, and thanks for the people who generously donated the Super Chats. And hope to see you. Oh, you albino. Yeah. So you came back from work or something? It's a shame. But hey, at least you can watch the stream back. So that is something at least. Of course, it's more fun to be there live. I understand that. But okay, I will see you then next stream on Thursday. And thank you all for being here.